Welcome back to another Foil Friday. Today we're talking about what the heck is up with these mast lengths. Why would you want a shorter mast versus a longer mast, and how is that going to change your riding? Bringing it to you today in the BVI. You can tell it's not Hood River because, well, it's just the way it is. We'll start with the longer mast. So why would you want a longer mast? And when I say longer mast, I consider that 85 centimeters or above. Kiters, wingers, riding in choppy water where it's deep, the longer mast is really beneficial. Where you're gonna feel, you know, the cons of a longer mast is if you're riding in shallow water, that's gonna be your huge pain in the butt. It's gonna turn a little bit slower, so it's gonna roll a little bit slower. It's gonna feel a little bit less reactive. The pros are you'll be able to cut through the chop much better. You'll be able to ride a lot higher on that foil. You'll be able to lean the foil over for better upwind angles. It just gives you a little bit more of a margin of error from foiling out of the water. Moving on to the shorter mast, that's 85 centimeters and shorter in my book. And you know, I think you asked a few different people, but I think it's right around that range. This is an 80 centimeter mast here. That size I really think is kind of like the jack of all trades. If you want one size mast to do everything, prone, sup, play behind a boat, do some winging, some kiting too, probably a little short for kiting, but it's doable. It's really just kind of the jack of all trades. You can do it all. You can ride it in, you know, shallow water, you know, and everything. You know, the shorter masts, the people that are riding the shorter masts, you know, they want that really direct feel, that really turny feel of the board. They don't so much care about, you know, kind of going up and down with the chop or, you know, having that longer margin of error or sailing those big upwind angles. They really are going for that turny feel, that like least amount of drag possible. See a lot of prone surfers, they're all gonna be riding, you know, unless they're towing or something like that, they're all gonna be riding 80 centimeter and shorter for the most part. Suppers are gonna be riding for the most part 80 centimeter and shorter. You know, it's, they don't have any need for the long masts like wingers and kiters would. So if you're just getting into the sport and you're trying to figure out what mast you should, you know, jump into at, you kind of want to think about where you're going to take the sport. So if you're a winger and you're getting into the sport and you're like, I want to wing, you know, I'm already a kiter, maybe I want to kite foil on the mast, you know, do everything, I would look at something, or you know, around 85 centimeters. It's going to give you a really nice range of size. If you're someone that, you know, wants to be able to prone and sup and wing and do all those things, I would look at somewhere between 75 and 85 centimeters. The shorter masts are typically easier for beginners also to, you know, get up and learn. You know, the falls are less extreme, you're not as high up, they're just a little bit easier to get up and learn. So that's what the heck's up with mast lengths. 75 to 85, prone, sup, wing, kind of, you know, the jack of all trade mast. 85 and bigger, it's really going to be wing and kite. I ride a 93, 94 when I'm winging out in the gorge. You know, if I'm traveling, I'll bring an 80 centimeter like I have here and just be able to do anything I want to do. Thank you guys so much for watching. See you out in the water. Tune in next Friday for some more tips.